When Pluto squares Mars in Sinistry, astrologers tend to become wary. It's a very intense combination of ego meeting fears with a volatile aspect that causes a lot of tension. For this reason, the square has a potential to go off like a volcano. There are even those who warn it could cause physical violence. This worst-case scenario is not overly common with this placement, and it should never be assumed that two people who share this aspect together will inevitably fall into an abusive pattern. I've seen abusive patterns with other seemingly innocent Sinistry. Despite this disclaimer, it can't hurt to be aware of the potential dangers and watch for a lack of emotional maturity in a couple, as well as important natal chart aspects on an individual level. When Pluto's fears are confronted by Mars' assertive energy in the direct abrasive way that is a square, Pluto may feel cornered and lash out. Similarly, if Pluto becomes very underhanded and aggravates Mars by not being direct, Mars can lash out. Fights between two people with this aspect could be loud and explosive, but the making up can feel like fireworks. Both are very passionate, especially Mars, who's prone to acting impulsive in the heat of the moment. The intense highs of this could be really enticing for Plutonian people. This is a very physical aspect too, and promotes a lot of intimate physical time together. If the couple tends not to fight a lot, they still find ways to blow off steam of the tension together. The kind of transformations that come from a combination like that involve Pluto looking deeper at what frightens them and their darkness, and Mars confronting issues of their ego and aggression, and even their actions that they take. The square still has plenty to learn from each other while keeping the ability to find common ground if they look for it. With the opposition, they're still relatively explosive and volatile energy, but while the two are pretty different, they have a more natural common ground than with the square. This could be spectacular or spectacularly awful, as they are still aware of how to push each other's buttons, so they do have more control over whether they antagonize each other or not. Pluto will still grasp for power, if unhealthy, and Mars will still react poorly as well, unless both parties can make an effort to transform together. There could still be a tendency to solve problems of ego clashes in the bedroom with the opposition. Physical intimacy could be used as a weapon. It's important to people with either the opposition or square be very honest with themselves and each other to move past the unhealthy patterns. On an ending note, with Pluto opposite or square Mars, I would recommend using a 5-degree orb or less, especially since these are major aspects and Pluto is a slow-moving outer planet. If you liked this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe, and thanks for watching!